All Don't let it go by. 5 months of the same question, and we're going to finish the album on the end. If it makes sense, and there should be a reason behind everything that we do today. I'm sure you've asked 10 people how to do something, and they're going to tell you 10 different ways. Thank you. try to create good habits and try to eliminate the bad habits of working time. What will happen today is, I'm going to tell you to try to do something. You're going to go there, you're going to do it once, you're going to hit the net, you're going to do it twice, you're going to hit the net, you're going to do it three times, you're going to hit the net. Even though we tell you that's the right way to do it, you're probably going to go back to what you were doing before, because that's what makes the ball go over the net. Let's try not to do this. Okay? That's going back to your bad habits, and there's no point of going to this clinic. Okay? Does that make sense? All right. Eventually, it'll work. Okay? So, Portobello, all about the system, all about the least amount of error. You see what that means, least amount of error? Okay? So, small things make big changes and results. Okay? So, we're going to try to show you a way that you can practice at home to become at least more efficient hitter. Okay? So, we're going to try to create a blueprint for you. We're going to give you some keys for the different phases of hitting. And if you take one or two things out of here, then our job is really done. Our goal is for you to take two or three things that you can use and really try to train for hitting. Okay? So, how are we going to do that? We're going to go through the phases of hitting. We're going to give you what the philosophy of your general mindset should be when you're performing part of that drill. And then we're going to give you some keys that you say, okay, did I get key number one? Did I get key number two? Did I get key number three? If I did it, I need to work on that. Okay? Amount of force to be able to hit the ball. Just keep that in mind, okay? don't go over how to handle a quick contact with the ball, it won't matter. Does that make sense? You jump the shot, you can do a beautiful opening, but if you can't find the ball, you're not going to hit it hard, and you're not going to hit it first. Okay? So I think that's one aspect of this technique that I like to focus on, is being able to get a completely solid contact on that ball. Okay? And it's something that we don't learn when we're young. We don't learn, we just say hit the ball, but we don't learn how to get this contact to the ball. So when we hit the ball, this is what we want to find right here. We want to be able to get full contact on the ball. And then if we can, to get on top of the ball. Easier for my taller people, a little harder for my not so tall people. Okay? So now when we are going to do that, what do you guys think your hand should be relaxed or it should be solid? When you're touching the ball. He said relaxed. He said solid. Alright, I relaxed for when you're missing hit that. Okay? Your hand should be relaxed when we get contact with the ball. Being relaxed doesn't mean that you don't hit it hard. Okay? What's the difference between the relaxed and not so relaxed? We're going from a serve to a hit. Serve, solid, strong, to a hit. You guys feel it? You can see the difference? Can you hear it? Solid, relaxed. Okay? That's the difference. You relax your hands, but you can still hit it very hard. Okay? So, right in your hand. Good. Up. They shouldn't pop that ball off their hand. There. So while you're waiting to get a hit, you can press the shoulder right here. Roll. Good. Now my hand position is exactly the way it should be. Exactly the way it should be right here. When they pop, let's do 15 of those. Let's try to get 15 good ones. Right here, two. Good, right there. Now, I want you to try to keep your hand in position and let it drop on that position. Good.
Try to get the
tired. Okay, the whole point of this is to learn good mechanics as well. Now, what we're going to do is, you see how everything starts to make it into more hitting, more hitting, more hitting. So these drills we can easily do every single day. Now, we're going to go from here, back down to here, but we're going to incorporate the elbow. You're going to go one, whatever, two, three, and then you're just going to drop the ball. Go exactly like that. Be careful it doesn't hit you in the face, so don't look down, please. It's here. We are not bringing our hands up yet. We are working just this last motion, which is what we do. So we come up here, we swing, and then we bring our hand down. So, it's going to be here, and then you just drop the ball and hit it, and you go straight up, just like that. Try to cup that ball here.
Leg is up from the beginning. The leg is up from the
network. We have what we call a four-step approach or a three-step approach. Okay, this is the ideal if you're not in an out-of-system situation, right? Out-of-system means the ball's not perfect, the center has to run, gives you a bad set, or the set's not great. Okay, we're talking here, pass is perfect, set is perfect, and we need to perform our approach. Okay, so transition is something that nobody ever does. We're going to work on it a little bit today, just so you guys get an idea. Okay, so regardless if you're doing a four-step approach or a three-step approach, your right leg is going to be forward. Okay, your right leg is going to be forward. My left knee is obviously the opposite of what I'm saying. Okay, now, what did we say the two key words were? Thank you. Whew, one person. So, this is all about momentum. So, if we want to build momentum, what is, let's say we have four steps. How is our pace going to be? Are we starting fast to slow? Are we going, slow to fast, or are we going same speed at the same for all four steps? Slow to fast. Anybody else say anything else? Everybody agrees? Okay, yeah. In order to build acceleration and momentum, we have to start slow and then fast. We don't want to go fast and then slow down. Okay? Now, in order to do that, let's go down to our steps. How are our steps going to be? Are we going to go fast? Are we going to go small to big, or is big to small, or same steps throughout the whole time? Medium, big, shoulder. Okay, so he's advanced, so he's saying, he's doing the right thing. He might confuse you with how he says it, though. Yes. Okay, so we want to go from small, bigger, biggest. And the way we say small, bigger, biggest is because we consider the last two steps almost simultaneous. Okay, so when we do a four-step approach, and here is one of our big keys. Our second step on a four-step approach, or our first step on a three-step approach, is on or behind the 10-foot line. Really important. On or behind the 10-foot line, which means right forward. The first step is practically going to show you where you're going to run, the path that you're going to run. I'm looking, if the set is perfect, I'll do this. This is my first step. That is it. That's all I do on a four-step approach. Here, if it is very tight, that's my first step. It's telling me I need to go in. My second step is a regular step, like I walk. On or behind the 10-foot line. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. The last two are the most important ones. They are, this is the pace. Okay, the last two steps are almost simultaneous. Why? Because we want to be able to get a high jump, right? Now, a couple of keys here that are very important. So second step on or behind the 10-foot line. Then last two steps have to be not straight. Okay, and there's a reason for that. Let's do this. We're going to go, you guys here have to be more on that side of the room. You guys stay here, straight line. Go on a straight line in the back line. Yeah, you can open up a little bit. Just that. Okay? What we're going to do, maybe right leg forward. Right leg forward, and we're going to go right, left, right, left. And we're going to jump. Okay? Right, left, and we're going to jump. Ready? I'm going to line here. So, ready? And go. Right, left, right, left. Stop, freeze. Okay. I don't know if you guys can see, but we have one person up here, two people back here, one person up here, back there, all the way up. Everybody is completely different. Okay? Now, why can I this is a 10-year mile, right? Which means you only have 10 feet to come forward, which means you should be landing somewhere here. Guess what? You guys are all the way on the other side of the net already. All of them. Same thing with this side. You see, River, she's the only one, and she's the only one that's just fell in the net. Everybody else is all the way on the other side of the net. So you see why we better take these giant steps. Go back to the end line. And there are two reasons why that is happening. And that's why I did this, so we can take a look. Let's try it again. Let's go on the line. Knowing that the red line is the net. Let me see you guys now. Now that you guys are a little tight. When we land, it's all going to say about the landing. When we land, our bodies should be cold. So we land, we spring, and our body is cold. Not our legs, we're not going to fit. So we jump, and our body lands forward. Right here. Because what happens? Most people, they will see this. Is my elbow down or up or back? In this position. Is it down, back, or up? You gotta say something. Who says down? Who says back? Who says up? Good. My elbow is in relationship to my trunk. So if I am here, my elbow is not down. My elbow is back, and that's a lot sometimes you get confused. So we can't bring this up as we're coming up in the air and bring this up. We're going to hurt our shoulder. So it's all according to your body. So it's here, back. It's here. I'm still back. I'm not down. Okay? So imagine you're holding a bow and arrow, right? And we're trying to extend it as much as we can. That's our position. And then we want this hand up. Now bring our hand. This hand is very important. This hand controls our balance. This hand, when it comes down, what do we do with this hand? What do you guys do with this hand? What are you bringing? Yeah, you want to bring it close to your chest. I say you pull the chain and you bring it to that Napoleon position. Okay, whichever way you want to think about it. You keep it close to your body. You don't move it away from you because you're going to drop. Okay? Here, pull the chain, keep your hand close, now have good balance. Elbow first. Elbow comes up and forward. I reach, swing, follow through. Got it? Okay, so, this is what we're going to do. Both sides. We're going to focus on the footwork. For now, I'm going to do this here, and I'm going to create a I'm not telling you you have to go left, right, left, and just straight up jump. That's not what I said. If you jump in the triangle, you're going to land in the middle. I want you to jump here, and you land in the triangle. Does that make sense? So there is a broad jump. It's just not as much as you would think it should be. So here, right, left. I'm going to stay right here, right off the triangle, and bump the ball up so that you hit it here and you should land within the triangle. Okay? So you stay right off the triangle. Everybody with the ball. Okay. right at you. They could be to your right. They could be slightly behind you. Guess what you need to do? Thank you. gym right here. Sit right there in front. So everybody will bring this line to it. Wait until the ball hits its highest spot, okay? And then you start your approach.